Today we're going to be in 1 Corinthians, starting in chapter 1, starting in verse 27. But God has chosen the foolish things of the world to put to shame the wise, and God has chosen the weak things of the world to put to shame the things which are mighty. And the base things of the world and the things which are despised, God has chosen, and the things which are not, to bring to nothing the things that are. Has it ever crossed your mind, because it sure crossed mine at times, how foolish I must look to God at times in my pride, or our cockiness, or our all-have-it-togetherness, if that's a phrase that works. You know, when we stand before an almighty God, the truth is, and Scripture tells us, that all of our wisdom stacks up to nothing but foolishness, and all of our righteousness, it stacks up to nothing but filthy rags. Do you feel inadequate at times for the task that God's called you to? I can relate. From the beginning of the Word of God to the end, and even in testimonies of people I know, it seems to me that God uses people all throughout Scripture who were completely inadequate in themselves, who were the lowest of low. He raises them up and He uses them for a purpose completely beyond themselves. I mean, look at David from the smallest of tribes, just a shepherd boy. God raised him up to be a king, to lead Israel. Look at Nehemiah, a man who was just a cupbearer in captivity, and God used him to go back and rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. Look at Esther, all the way up to the disciples who were ordinary, uneducated men. God used them for a purpose completely beyond themselves. You may have been told once or twice in your life, and I have too, that God will never put on us more than we can bear. And people mean well when they say that, but it seems to me, in experience and in the Word of God, that God purposely leads us through circumstances that are completely beyond ourselves. If we were adequate in ourselves, if we were righteous enough in ourselves, if we were wise enough in ourselves, we wouldn't have needed a Savior. We're not. We need God. And in those times, He leads us through those circumstances. We just lean back on Him because He has overcome this world, and He can lead us through. When we're weak, then we're strong. So if you feel inadequate for the task that God has called you to, if you feel inadequate in the circumstance that you're in and wonder how you're going to get through it, know that you're in great company with all the great men of faith in the Word of God. And know that as we trust God through those circumstances, we'll see mighty victories, because God has led us through those, and Scripture tells us, so that He'll be glorified. So, Lord, be glorified in us.
But He is spotless and you're holy, and I can never compare in the sinful garments I wear. Oh, but Jesus stepped between the Father and me. Now the way that He sees His Son, I'm just